Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're building a SwiftUI app with a custom launch screen. We'll create a programmatic launch screen as well as a storyboard-based launch screen just to welcome users into our app. Let's create a new SwiftUI project. If you want to add this to an existing project, feel free to do so. I'm just going to create a new iOS app template. Ooh, went a little fast there. I'm just going to call it launch screen example, make sure I'm on SwiftUI, language Swift. Now let's go ahead and dive on in. So because we're just kind of focusing on the launch or loading screen of our app, I'm not even going to change anything from our template. And instead, I'm going to press on the plus button in the bottom right, or you can right click on your project navigator. And from there, you'll select new file from template. Then you're going to select the SwiftUI view. Let's go ahead and call it launch screen view. Hit create. So what we're going to do in this view is while the app is loading, we want to show this to the user. We'll even create a little timer that has a little load bar until the app actually launches. So at the very top here under our structure, I'm going to create a state private variable. And we're going to call this one isActive. And we'll set this to be false. So essentially, while this is not active, we're going to have the load screen. When we make the transition over to it being active, then we'll show the user the content view or whatever other view we want to boot to. So in our variable body here, we're going to get rid of our text that says hello world, and we're going to say if is active. I'm going to add a brace here. We will go to the content view, or you can add the other view you want to go to. If you have like a home view or something, that's where I would put that there. Then we're going to say else. Add our brace, and this is where we're actually going to be adding the customization for our launch screen. So I'm going to create a Z stack to create the background here, and I'm going to add a linear gradient. I know there's a couple different ways to do gradient. This is just the way that I like to do it. So we'll go ahead and add the gradient. We'll say gradient with a capital G. Then we'll add another bracket, we'll add our colors, and then within here we'll add our array of the different colors. So I'm going to do color dot black, comma, and then maybe color dot purple. I think that would be a pretty cool look. Outside of this first bracket here, we're going to add a comma and then a space. So we're still within the kind of bracket of the linear gradient. From here, we're going to add the start point. Now we can have the speed dot top, do dot top trailing. We'll then add another comma and we'll add the endpoint. And maybe bottom leading. You can play around with these, whatever you kind of like best, feel free. Great, and that is our gradient. So I'm just gonna move this bracket back up here so it looks a little bit cleaner. And outside of that bracket, we're gonna add dot edges, ignore safe area, and we'll set that to be all. And you'll see our gradient kind of goes everywhere. Still within our Z stack here, we're gonna go ahead and add a V stack now. And this is where we can add the image, or, you know, maybe our app icon or the text of introducing our app. I don't have an app icon currently. I'm just kind of using this as an example, and I'm going to use an SF image. So I'm going to do system names.fill. But if you have your app icon or anything else within your assets, instead of the system name, you'll then put that image name. So let's set this to be resizable. Let's also have this be scaled to fit. And it's currently massive, so let's go ahead and add a frame here. I'm going to have the width be 100, and then the height also be 100, because it's a little larger than charge right now. Let's also set the foreground style, and we'll change this to be dot white, which should change the color of the star to white. Wonderful. And we can also add some padding afterwards, too. Let's now add some text. We can say, you know, loading, dot, 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 or maybe even welcome to our app. We'll add some style here as well. So maybe headline, or we can even do large title. Add some foreground style as well. And let's also make this white so it pops off the screen. Now that's pretty cool. You know, it tells the user that we're loading into their app. But something that we can also do, because we are doing this programmatically, is maybe we can make our gradient animated. We can kind of have things moving on the screen. A great way to kind of show progress is actually by using the built-in progress view. So you just start with a capital P and do progress view. make the V capital, you'll notice that we get a little spinning bar. Now, it does not show very well in this gradient. So if we want to change the color, we'll need to add a dot, new progress view style. And from here, we can actually add the circular progress view style. I'm going to use the second one here. Or if you want to save time, you could do the third one and you can add the tint. We'll do dot white. So progress style. So dot progress view style within the brackets, circular progress view style within those brackets, tint colon dot white. And you can see now we have this kind of load screen, this kind of like loading circle that's moving for us there. All right, we're not quite out of the woods yet. What we need to do is we essentially need to have a mode. So is active could be true, because when we're booting up, it's false. And we don't have anything in here that's going to set that to actually be true currently. So at the end of our Z stack, so let's go ahead and go out of it. We'll do dot on appear. And then we're actually going to add a brace instead of those brackets. We're going to say dispatch Q dot main dot async, the capital A after. We're going to add a deadline. Then a colon, we can have it be dot now plus, and then we can choose a number for the amount of seconds that it takes to actually boot into the other spot. We'll then add another brace here. We'll say with animation, one more brace is active equals true. Okay, so you can even see on the preview here when it does load after 3 seconds, it's going to take us to our Hello World content view. If we were to launch this app right now, it would actually just take us immediately to the content view. We need to go to our app file, so it should be whatever your project name is, and then app, so launch screen example app. You'll see here that we have our main here, and it's basically saying, okay, when I launch this, I want you to go immediately into the content view. We're going to change this to be launch screen view instead. Alrighty, well, let's go ahead and build our app. I'm going to do it on the iPhone 16 Pro. Go ahead and boot it up and see how it looks. All right, here's our app. We're loading in. We can see the progress bar. And now we're presented with our content view. We can do whatever we want with the app. So that's how to do it programmatically. Now let's take a look at how to do it with a storyboard, which is a more static view. So what we'll want to do is we can either press the plus button again, or we can right click in our project navigator, new file from template, and under the user interface, you'll see that there is actually the launch screen option. You can also search for it here if you're unable to find it. And let's go ahead and create it. I like to call my launch screen one word, kind of camel case ask, and let's go ahead and hit create. If you're not a pro at UIKit, don't worry. It's very easy. Kind of think of it as like scuffed Canva. It's going to actually provide us with a label. We can even double click on it and change what it says here. So if I were just to say, you know, my app, we can even add an image by going to our image view. You can drag and drop this onto the screen. You'll need to press on this right tab bar here if we want to make any changes in UIKit. So in the case of the image view, if we had any images added to our assets catalog, they'd appear at the top. Otherwise, we have the system. We did the start for the other one. Let's go ahead and do like a person.fill this one. You can change things like the tint, the background color. So if I were to make this purple or more pinky, right? You can think of these as like the properties of SwiftUI, but you kind of just have a menu to kind of change them, right? You can even see like the content mode and things like that. In order to change the background, you can select on view or just click anywhere in the kind of empty area of the phone screen. And you'll notice that we have the background color. Currently it's set to custom, and you can actually use the color wheel to change that. I'll sometimes just come up here and just grab one from the top. I'm using this light gray color, apparently. But you can use this object library here in order to kind of scroll. You'll see a lot of these are more, you know, buttons and things that people interact with. But if you want to add some text, you can add the label. You can use the UI image view, right? You don't have to be a pro at using UIKit to kind of get this launch screen going. This one's super basic. You can go much more in depth with it. So in order to have this launch screen appear, let's go back to that main app file, and we're just going to boot to our content view. Now we're going to click on our app file at the top here. Under targets, we're going to go to info. And you'll see we have a whole bunch of keys here. We're going to press on the plus button here. So under the bundle name, I'm just going to press on that plus button. It's going to create a new kind of tab underneath. We're going to scroll down to where we see the launch. And we're going to want launch screen interface file base name. And hit enter. And under the value, we're going to put our launch screen. Right, so this storyboard, whatever you called it, I called mine launch screen. I'm gonna hit return. We'll also go to our general here. Scroll down a bit. Under the app icons and launch screen, let's go ahead and set our storyboard. Hit return. Alrighty, so we should boot our app and we should see this. Not very well made. Yours should look a lot better than mine. Not very well made storyboard launch screen that I made in like 2 seconds. And we can see here the iPhone 16 has my app while it's loading up. You'll notice that this one, while it is also static, normally when we're booting things up, you'll kind of get stuck on the simulator on like a white screen or like a black screen, depending on whether or not you're using a light mode or dark mode. And this will actually replace that as that static image. So that took a while to load because it was our first time booting in a while. So let's go ahead and close it. Open up the launch screen, we see my app. Because it's a very lightweight app, it loaded like that. So that's how you can create a static launch screen. So those programmatic launch screens, fully dynamic, customizable in SwiftUI. The storyboard launch screen, ideal for very simple static design. Something to also keep note of is in this launch screen, you will want to add auto constraints. So if you select on, let's say this person.fill, and you go down here to the constraints, you can actually set how far you want these images, these elements to be from one another. So if I wanted this to be 0 and 0 from the side of the screen, maybe 20, and then, you know, 300, add those constraints. And then I believe this one already has constraints set up. If you use the label from when it's first created, it looks like it already has constraints. Now this is usable on iPad, you know, any size iPhone, so just keep that in mind. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial on launch screens. Let me know in the comments down below what you're creating and what apps you're working on. And remember to dream big, code bigger, and we'll see you next time.